morning. My name is Kat. So today we're going to brew Starbucks Ethiopia using Cypher. So what I love about this brewing method is that it gives you a deep cup of coffee because of the paper filter, and the flavor notes of this coffee is more evident because we're going to use vapor pressure to brew our coffee. So this is a combination of artistry and science. So to start off, we're going to measure 385 grams of hot water that we're going to put on our lower chamber. On top of our bean heater and set the temperature to high. This will help the water to achieve its optimum temperature. We'll just leave it for a while. And earlier, I have prepared 25 grams of Starbucks Ethiopia that I grind using number 5 paper filter setting in our kneading grinder. But I also make sure that before and after I grind my coffee that there is no coffee residue inside the grinder, for it might affect the flavor of our coffee. So what I'm getting right now is layers of spice and dark cocoa notes from its dry aroma. You can try it. Thank you. So we're going to now assemble the paper filter in our filter screen assembly. Making sure that it's properly locked and hooked so it will be secured for the entire brewing process. We're now going to put this upper chamber on top of our lower glue. Just tilted and not yet sealed because you don't want the water to go up yet without its proper temperature. So we will now wait for constant bubbles to appear as a sign that our water is ready for brewing. So this will take for a while. So while waiting, let me share to you about my coffee, Starbucks Ethiopia. I chose this coffee because I want to give honor to the rich coffee heritage of Starbucks of Ethiopia, and also share to you the exceptional flavor experience of this coffee. So Ethiopia is the birthplace of coffee, where the legend says that the goat herder Kaldi discovered the magic of this plant 12,000 years ago from the small village of Kaffa, Ethiopia. So in ancient times, coffee was eaten as only eaten as a fruit and not as a drink, but eventually they made it a beverage where they called it kahwa, meaning to prevent from sleep. And later on, coffee traveled around the globe, across the Europe, Latin America, and Asia Pacific region. So in Ethiopia, where it is the largest coffee producer in Africa, and it produced 200,000 tons of Arabica beans per year, wherein 98% of coffee was produced in small farms. So just imagine that the livelihood of many people depends on coffee farming. So Starbucks really taking care of sourcing this coffee because they want to help coffee farmers who produce Arabica beans, also applying a Starbucks roast to it, creating a specific taste profile. So it will be unique only for Starbucks and also highlighting the flavor of Ethiopian beans. So I think we're now seeing constant bubbles. We can now seal the upper chamber to the lower chamber. So what's happening right now is the air expanding and pressurized, creating a vapor pressure that it will move the water upward to our upper chamber. So Starbucks Ethiopia is a fully washed coffee and a medium-bodied coffee. It will offer you a soft, velvety, dark cocoa notes on your palate with the hints of peppery spice and also balancing it with citrus, sweet citrus at the end of your palate. So we will just wait that most of the water is already inside the upper chamber. The temperature to medium. To maintain the temperature of the water, and of course, we don't want the water to go down yet without our coffee. Start our 90 seconds timer. So we will now incorporate the coffee to the water. Holding the coffee 4 times. Or just make sure all coffee is properly saturated. So folding our coffee is very important because it releases the trapped carbon dioxide in our coffee. So we will just wait for 45 seconds before we stir again our coffee. So 45 seconds is up. We have to stir now the coffee 4 times. So stir, we have to stir the coffee because it will evenly extract the flavor of our coffee. This coffee using Chemex, because Chemex will also give you a similar clean cup, but it will highlight the brighter notes of the coffee. So our 90 seconds is up. We will now turn off our bean heater and remove it, the siphon from here. Stir the coffee again 4 times. And now the vapor pressure is shrinking. It will vacuum the brewed coffee down to our lower chamber. So we will wait for a perfectly round mound as a sign that we brewed our coffee perfectly. Just like this. So we have to remove our upper chamber, tilt, rotate, and pull. We place it on top of our stand. So, with your permission, let me taste a sample of your coffee to check its flavor consistency and quality. It's perfectly brewed. So here's your tall Starbucks Ethiopia Siphon Brewed Coffee.